Hey guys, Dr. Schulte here. Today I want to give you three exchanges that you can do in your diet to help maximize the impact. So maximize your investment. I want to help you minimize your chances of heart disease, cancer, diabetes. And so these are the three places where I would start as far as making a change in your diet. So when we look at nutrition or food, your food, the choices that you make with your food are either going to help heal you or going to harm you. And we want to give you the biggest changes to help heal your body. So here we go. Number one is I want you to exchange bad fats for good fats. What are these bad fats? They're hidden all over the place. But the ones we want to keep an eye on are hydrogenated oil. So take a look at your food and see if there's any hydrogenated oil, partially hydrogenated oil, trans fats, or vegetable oils. And I know, at least for me, I was pretty naive back then, but some of you guys still may be there. When we hear the word vegetable, we tend to think, man, vegetable oil, that's got to be good for me, right? And the problem is, it's not. It's what's known as really, really inflammatory to the body. And the reason that comes into play is we all have cells in our body, and these cells are permeable. And that means that they allow nutrients to come in and they allow toxins to come out. When we start to eat bad fats, that causes inflammation of the cell wall and causes an inability for those nutrients to get in and the toxins to come out. That can lead to all sorts of neurotoxic illnesses. It can lead to cancers. It can lead to chronic fatigue. It congests that cell, and we see all of these inflammatory things start to happen. So everything from heart disease, strokes, cancers, all of these have inflammation at the root of the problem. And so the first thing we want to do is, like I said, to remove that fat. And when we're looking at different foods or different minerals or vitamins, I would say that the number one missing nutrient in the country today, in the United States, are good fats. And so in a little bit here, I'll show you what to exchange those with. But right now, look at those four things, and we want to get rid of them, okay? So that's number one. The second exchange that we want to do are our meats. So we want to remove commercial meat, and we want to replace that with grass-fed meat. Going back to the fats, when we look at our meats, they can either, again, be really healthy for us or really harmful. When we're looking at the ratio, we want a ratio of omega-6 to omega-3, about a 4-to-1 ratio. So when we're eating grass-fed meats, we get that proper ratio, and that really helps our body heal. When you're eating commercial meats or just regular commercial meat, that ratio goes from 4-to-1 to 40 or 50-to-1. And again, that causes massive inflammation in the body. And so what we want to do is we want to switch to grass-fed meat. If you look at the studies out there are a lot of studies out there on commercial meat that say that it leads to cancer and heart disease. And that, again, that goes back to the inflammation in the body. So we want to remove those. The other problem with grain-fed meat or commercial meat is that it's grain-fed. So these cows are designed by God to eat grass, organic, healthy. What happens is this grass is sprayed with chemicals. It's sprayed with herbicides. These cows are injected with antibiotics. They're injected with hormones. So when we start to eat those cows and eat that meat, we're then taking in an accumulation of all of that toxicity, all of that harmful inflammation to the body. So the second thing we want to do is exchange those meats. Number three is we want to exchange refined sugar and refined grains or processed grains. So some areas that can hide here are white pastas, white breads, white rice. All of those things, again, are going to be inflammatory to the body. So the reason that this comes into play is when you eat those processed grains and processed sugars, what happens is that causes a spike in glucose. When you get a spike in glucose over an extended period of time, that increases or causes a spike in your insulin. And when we get a spike in glucose for long enough, or a lot of the other sugars to look for, fructose, sucrose, glucose, they all spike that. We spike the insulin. That causes a spike in leptin, which is our fat-burning hormone. And again, we become insulin-resistant or leptin-resistant. Those are when we're resistant to the hormone that helps our body burn fat, we start to accumulate fat. So a lot of you that aren't able to lose weight, you've tried everything. Start to look at these fats. Start to look at these grains. Start to look at these processed sugars and processed foods. So we really want to change that. But, so real quick, just to sum it up. We want to replace the good fats. What are some of those good fats? Coconut oil, macadamia nut oil, avocado oil. Avocados are great. MCT oil. That's something that you can put in your coffee. We're going to do videos on that in the future here. So again, what to remove? All vegetable oils. Canola oil. They market that as a healthy oil. Get rid of that. Soybean oil. Get rid of that as well. With your meats, buy organic, USDA organic meat. That is a little bit more on the more expensive or more of an investment, but it is well worth it when you take into account that you're not getting those hormones, you're not getting those antibiotics, and you're really allowing that body to heal and that communication within that cell to go in and out, release that toxin, and bring in that nutrition. And the last one is we want to swap out your sugars. So three different things that you can do with that. You can use stevia. That's my number one. So look for stevia. Look for another, at least healthier alternative would be coconut sugar. And the last one would be xylitol. So those are the simple changes that you can make. I want you guys to start there. Make sure you've done that. If you've done it, if you like the information, give me a thumbs up. If you've done that, make a comment below. I want this page to be all about you guys getting in communication with me. If you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, I want you guys to have a great day, and this is an excellent, excellent first step to make that change. Congratulations for those of you that are already done it, and that's your homework for this week. You guys take care. Have a great day.